stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible,
with liberty
and justice
for all.
So why is your counselor important to you?
The counselors are important here at Granite Park Junior High because they provide a lot of resources for our students.
My counselor is really important to me because she helped me through a lot.
Because she helps like all the students out, like all, she likes to help a lot of people out. And because like if you need something, you can go out to her and she can like, ask her for it.
She, you know, at times when it was rough, she sat down with me and actually talked and cared for me. When I got injured, she always checked up on me.
They are there to make sure that first off that we get in the right class, but also when students are having a bad day, or sometimes even when adults are having a bad day, just to kind of debrief and help us process that and help us have the right skills to take on those challenges of school life.
She helps me with my classes and finding things that I've lost.
And she's just really kind of really nice and respected to like everybody in the school.
What letter of pride do teacher represent?
I think you can find representation in every single letter of pride. But the first one that comes to my mind is excellence.
Respect.
Integrity.
Respect.
Because she likes to respect her students. She's really respectful.
She really represents integrity. She always does everything for, not just for the right purpose, but because it's right. She is always prepared.
They are so excellent at what they do, and they strive to make sure that we all feel comfortable and safe in this school.
Because she's always helping me out, probably integrity too. So once again, she's always helping me out.
When it's your birthday and she calls you down, she always has something to give you. She always has a note ready for you.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson.
Thank you, Ms. Bowers.
Thank you, Ms. Ballish.
Thank you, Ms. Bowers, Ms. Ballish, and Ms. Johnson. You guys rock.
Have a good time, I fi drop it low. No need for rush now, come and take it slow. You can lead now, come and show the way. We better jump up, party till late. La 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 la, moving right. Drop it till it gets low.
Drop,
see me that thing. Drop it down low.
Do you speak more than one language?
Yeah.
What language do you speak?
Arabic.
What language do you speak?
Somali.
So Darian, I hear you speak Samoan.
I speak like a tiny, tiny bit.
So Ephraim, I'm gonna try to learn some Spanish. Can you help me with that? Because
sure.
I'm feeling Spanish class.
Sure.
Can you say something in Arabic like, hi, how are you doing?
Assalamu alaikum, shonkum.
So can you like greet someone, like can you say hi, how are you doing?
Okay, if I get this wrong, Arsamons, come correct me. Cool. How you say hi is Talofa.
Talofa.
And then how to say how are you, Talofa, or my way.
Can you say something in Somali like hi, how are you doing?
Salam alaikum,
sir. Choose something that, that's kind of difficult, but not too difficult to say in Spanish.
Yo quiero hablar español.
Ephraim, do you think you can say that?
Assalamu alaikum, shonkum.
Can you repeat that for him?
Assalamu alaikum, shonkum.
Assalamu alaikum, shonkum.
No, no,
no.
Assalamu alaikum,
sir. What?
So basically, kind of like the same thing. So, assalamu alaikum, say it to hi.
Say it again.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Oh, so, salam alaikum.
Malaiko. Did I say it right?
Salam alaikum.
Oh, oh, sorry, I'm the one. Yo quiero hablar.
Quiero.
Quiero.
Yes. Yo quiero hablar español.
Yo quiero español. Assalam. Can you say that again?
Assalamu alaikum.
Shalom.
Oh, Islamo alaikum shalom.
No, not shalom. Like salam
alaikum. Salam alaikum. Set hi.
Umawe. So talofa samola umawe.
Talofa or my way.
Or my way.
Because.
Let me teach you a name, right?
Uh-huh.
You want to try to pronounce it. So, ufufu. Frefre. And your turn. Refre. Ube mubu mubu sas.
I remember ufufu.
So, ufufu.
Have a good time, I fi drop it low. No need for rush now, come and take it slow. You can lead now, come and show the way. We better jump up, party till late. La 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 la, moving right. Drop it till it gets slow.
Drop
it down low.
Think of the mind as a still pool of water. Each thought is like a raindrop. It creates a ripple on the surface. If it starts raining very hard or it's perhaps a little windy, then the pool might become so cloudy that we can't see what's on the bottom. But the potential to return to our still pool of water is still there. In fact, by training the mind, the ripples naturally begin to slow. And as the surface of the pool becomes still, it gets easier to see what's beneath the surface. Sometimes we might like what we see, at other times, well, maybe not so much. Now, occasionally finding things we don't like may sound off-putting, but it's really important, because it's part of letting go of those things. Accepting what's in our mind also helps us to be less critical of ourselves. It can even help us to be less critical of others. So we start to feel more content in life, to experience more harmonious relationships, and to be more at ease with the world around us.
And I'm going to show you a really simple way of getting some more headspace in your life. So make sure that you're sitting comfortably. I'd actually like you to begin with your eyes open and just taking a big deep breath, breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. As you breathe in, just feeling the lungs expand as they fill with air. And as you breathe out, just feeling the body soften a little bit as you gently close the eyes. And you can just allow the breath to return to its natural rhythm, in and out of the nose. And as you pause for a moment, just noticing the feeling of the body, the weight of the body pressing down against the seat beneath you. Contact of the feet on the floor, the hands and the arms and the legs. Noticing any sounds around you. And as you pause, just noticing how the body feels. Starting to notice how the body's breathing, that movement of breath in the body. So some people feel it in the stomach. For others, it's in the chest or around the diaphragm. Not breathing in any special way. We're just starting to notice that rising and falling sensation. If you can't feel anything, just gently placing your hand on the stomach.
Now, as you follow that movement, the mind will wander away, almost inevitably. No problem if it does, perfectly natural. But as soon as you realize it's wandered, just acknowledging that, letting it go, and just coming back again to that rising and falling sensation. And then just for a moment now, letting go of any focus on the breath, just letting the mind do whatever it wants, just for a few seconds. If it wants to think, let it think. And then bringing the attention back to the body, back to that feeling of contact, back to any sounds around you. And you can just gently open your eyes in your own time. So how does it feel having taken a few minutes out of the day? Does the body feel any different? Does the mind feel any different? Don't worry if there's still lots of thoughts running around. That's perfectly normal. Remember, this is a skill we're learning, and it takes a little bit of time. But before you do jump up, before you get on with things, just take a few moments just to appreciate that feeling, to really acknowledge what it's like to take some time out, to allow the body and the mind to unwind.